DJI Osmo Pocket was released back in 2018. Now, at the time, it cost around $350. Nowadays, you can find it used for about $150. So, just what do you get with this little pocket camera? Well, there's a 12 megapixel sensor, 4K video up to 60 frames per second, and a 3-axis gimbal, which, spoiler alert, is actually really good. In terms of video, you've got 4K at 24, 30, and 60 frames per second, and of course you've got the PAL equivalents of 25 and 50 frames per second. 1080p is also at those same frame rates, with one asterisk. We'll get to that in a second. But yeah, image quality on the DJI Osmo Pocket is surprisingly good. You know, it's a small little 1 over 2.3 size sensor, but what they're getting out of that's actually genuinely impressive. And one of the big advantages of the Osmo Pocket is just the sheer size itself. You know, if you're trying to vlog in public and you're walking around with like a mirrorless camera or God forbid, like a big DSLR, everyone pays attention. You walk around with the Osmo Pocket, like literally no one cares. And that's the thing, like the average person who's not into photography or video, they don't even really know what the device is. It's like, it just doesn't even register. No one pays attention. And of course, you've got things like follow mode, which kind of sounds like a gimmick, but it actually works really well. I mean, if you're filming by yourself, you could just do these like natural like walk and talk segments, and the camera does a great job of tracking it. And another thing that's really surprised me too is how well this camera has held up in low light. You know, at first I was a little bit hesitant, thinking, well, it's a small sensor, it's not really any bigger than a phone or an action camera, so what's the point of this camera? But to my surprise, low light on this camera actually looks a lot better than the low light you're getting from a phone, and it looks a lot better than the low light than you're getting from an action camera as well. In terms of stabilization, the Osmo Pocket is genuinely good. You know, even though it's only a 3-axis gimbal, it does a pretty amazing job. You know, in the past few weeks, I've been filming a lot for my second channel, which is basically a vlog channel, and so I've tested a lot of different cameras just walking around the neighborhood, doing these sort of walk and talk type segments. To my surprise, the Osmo Pocket seemed to handle the stabilization better than even a lot of the action cameras that I tested. It was just genuinely smooth, clean footage. Now, the only time you will have a problem, and it's not really a problem so much, but it's something you'll notice, is with the Osmo Pocket, when you're walking straight ahead and holding the camera just straight out in front of you like that, it's only a 3-axis gimbal, so it's not compensating for that up and down movement, so you will see kind of footsteps in that sense. But I mean, even then, it's not really jarring, it's not too much, it's still good, usable footage. Slow motion on the Osmo Pocket is good, but it is the only critique that I really have. It does 1080p at 120 frames per second, except the catch is, you don't have access to that. Like if you go through the menus and you look at 1080p, the only options you'll see are 24, 30, and 60 frames per second. That 120 frames per second file is just baked into a slow motion file, kind of the way you'd find on like an iPhone or something like that. It would be fine, except for that file only comes in a 30 frames per second format. So if you're like me and you're filming in a 24 frames per second timeline, you've got this 30 frames per second version of 120 frames per second slowed down that you're trying to fit into a 24 frames per second timeline, and it's just, it would be so nice to just have access to the 1080 120 frames per second file, but you don't have access to that. The other weird critique I have of the slow motion on the Osmo Pocket is it crops in a lot. Like for whatever reason, you know, you've got a normal like 26 millimeter full frame equivalent. The second you hit slow motion, it just punches into that file like a noticeable amount. I mean, it almost becomes like a telephoto lens at that point. Another aspect that might be frustrating to some is the LCD screen on the back is tiny. It's literally the size of a postage stamp. It is a touch screen and you do have access to the menus from there, but you're trying to do like these swipe gestures in a space that's literally about the size of like 1 inch by 1 inch. You know, you have the option to plug your phone in, And this is a big complaint that a lot of people had with the original Osmo Pocket is you don't have access to connect it to your phone unless you buy an actual secondary accessory. You know, the only way to access the app is to plug your phone into that little dongle that it comes with. And that in and of itself is a weird setup. It's not particularly sturdy. You know, your phone is sideways and you're relying on just that tiny little dongle to kind of like hold your phone in place. You know, there is like a little sort of cage or a rig for it to like help hold it steady. But once you start building out the Osmo Pocket, you kind of take out the pocket in the Osmo Pocket. You know, the whole point of this device is it's supposed to be tiny and fit in your pocket. You start having this whole cage rig setup, it's like, it starts becoming bigger and bigger. And at that point, it's like, why not just use a mirrorless camera? And of course, I think the most obvious question you have to ask yourself is, do you really need a DJI Osmo Pocket? I mean, in this day and age, the image quality from phones is actually really good and stabilization is starting to catch up. So what point does a device like this really serve? Well, the Osmo Pocket kind of falls into a funny category of just sort of emotional, impulsive, right brain decisions. You know, I don't think you're buying this because it logically, rationally, analytically fits some sort of need in your life. I think you probably already have that need covered. Instead, I think you're buying something like this because you just enjoy using it. I mean, you know, in the time that I've been using this, I have had so much fun using this camera. I don't need this camera at all, but I enjoy using this camera. And I think finally, with the price coming down as low as $150, it might start making sense to some people. Like, I don't think you need this camera by any stretch of the imagination. But I do think you would enjoy this camera if you actually had it and you were actually using it on a regular basis. Anyway, I think that's all I've got for today, guys. Thanks for watching. I'll see you again next time.